Yeah.
How's it going?
I started, but there's nobody here.
You gotta stay close to us.
I'm close.
Okay.
We got three.
So, what's up, guys? Kaiju here, Falcon Sports. I have with me today Matt from Evike. We're in booth 3826, and you having a good time, bro?
Yeah. I mean, this is my 60th year doing this now, so
it's only my fourth. Man.
Yeah. So you know, it's fun to see the show kind of progress, and as many things don't change, there's a whole lot of new changes and stuff coming not just in the firearm industry, but also in airsoft. So a lot of cool stuff coming out. Also, it's been fun all the time.
Oh, nice.
They're doing promotions and stuff there, so.
And tell everybody where your booth is.
Our booth number is 8009, just in case you're here at the show. We're down in the law enforcement section next to Chris.
Oh, Chris. Crytek Chris.
Yeah, Crytek.
Crytek Chris. Cool. Awesome. Have you noticed, like, less foot traffic this year?
Well, yesterday seemed, you know, pretty busy. And I feel like a lot of people try to get a lot done in one day. Because it was busy all the way up until closing.
Right.
There was, like, mass exodus leaving. Today feels like a really slow start. Like, there weren't a whole lot of people in the morning. I know we opened at 8, we're just kind of like,
hey, where is everybody?
Hello? But, like, more people are, like, trickling in. So I think we were just getting a later start today.
Right.
But overall, I mean, you know, I think we've all had a pretty good reception.
Have you checked out anything cool or fun since you've been here?
Yeah. One of the ones that I really wanted to see is Strike Industries came out with an auto drop bag.
Oh, wow.
So if you're familiar with, like, Cobalt Kinetics, they developed an AR that injects its mags into. It's a really cool system, but it's proprietary. You have to buy a Cobalt Kinetics AR just to do it.
Oh, wow.
So Strike went, okay, we like the idea, but we want something that's universally applicable to an existing AR-15 platform. So they have a magazine they're developing that has almost like a plastic follower from the AEG magazine. Yeah, like, so it has a follower on the side where the mag release locks in, you know, the side of the magazine has that square window. Well, as the plastic follower loads your round into the chamber, at the last round, when it jacks in, that follower comes up and bumps the mag release, drops the mag.
Wow.
Yeah, so not only are they offering, like, a stable of magazine, but they're also introducing that drop-in chamber for existing mags. So I thought that was pretty cool. Yeah.
How's the mic like?
Tiring.
Yeah, tiring.
Some good restaurants. But, you know, we also, we had the Stanley Arms kind of get together last night, where we watched a whole bunch of luchador fights, a bunch of Libre
themed
party, and they had full on, like, ringside girls. And
were you wearing your recreation pants?
I wasn't.
Oh.
I came in normal clothes, and I felt underdressed.
Oh, that's awesome. Hey, guys. Be sure to subscribe to Falcon Airsoft on Facebook, Evike Airsoft on Facebook.
Airsoft Evike.
Yeah. My bad.
Well, that's cool.
And 3826 and
8009.
We'll catch you guys later.